Now, when it comes to hunting does and shooting does, it's funny, people use that word interchangeably. Some people feel like harvest is a better, softer feel to shooting deer. I look at it like, if you want to make a distinction between the two, I harvest does, I shoot bucks, I hunt bucks. Does are more, they're there for the picking. You shoot them when you have to, you shoot them when you don't shoot them when you don't have to. It's almost like a fruit that you're harvesting and you're actually doing that each year. But there is a good time to shoot does, and there's a lot of bad times to shoot does as it relates to your entire property focus. Now, I'm not saying to go out there and shoot does if you don't need to. I have another video, or it's kind of a rant, but if you have a personal responsibility, just because you have a tag does not mean you need to shoot a doe. Just because you want venison does not mean you need to shoot a doe. I know people that have wanted venison, they take two or three does, and all of a sudden they don't have deer in their land for 2 or 3 years because they have to wait for it to become overpopulated somewhere else and move in. Up north, UP of Michigan, lakeshore of Lake Superior, there's areas that are 5 deer per square mile or less, and that includes box does and fawns. So you shoot 4 does in a deer yard area with your buddies, then all of a sudden the next year, the year after, you just knocked out a deer herd for a 4 square mile area because there's no does in those areas, and because it's such a low population, other does don't move in. So it's a good time to shoot does in a great time. We're entering December right now. Literally tomorrow starts the 4-day gun season. You can use any weapon for a doe only season in the state of Wisconsin. I love this time for shooting does if you need to shoot does. I don't want people to think that you have to shoot does because of this video. There's a right time. To me, right now, entering December, and we're at December 11th right now. And as we're moving forward, my daughter's birthday, Autumn, is tomorrow, December 12th. So I'm going to go up and see her tonight, go to lunch with her, that kind of thing. Can't wait. But also, a great time for this year is that doe season. And I like this doe season this time of year, because you're working on your deer numbers for next year. You're reducing over-browsing for next year. It's the same thing. It doesn't matter if you do it early season and do it for this year, or do it right now and do it for next year. It's the same thing. It's the same focus. You're having the same effect on your land. But this is a great time, because when you pull the trigger on a doe, and I'll compare this to the worst time. The absolute worst time for you to shoot a doe is opening day of gun season, unless you already have a buck down. Because you shoot a doe, you spook deer, you have to go retrieve those does, and now you're spooking deer off the land, you're leaving your scent on the land, you're accessing areas that you shoot to that you probably don't normally walk through, and so you're really on a small parcel, let's say even up to 100, 200, 300, 400 acres, if you shoot multiple does on opening day. I had a client up north, 80 acres, and he shot 5 does on one opening day with he and his buddies and his brother, and then they shot 3 does, the season before, the season after on opening day, and then they complain about not seeing any deer in the late season. Well, that's what happens. Shoot does on opening day of deer season. That should be the most secure, low risk, low pressure time to the local deer herd. So you're actually attracting deer, promoting them to the next age class, building a quality herd. And oh, by the way, if you do all that, you get a quality hunt. So if you're shooting does at the wrong time, you can destroy your land. And that's why I don't start my habitat improvements until after the season's over, or maybe at the last few days in December at the most. Our doe season goes through all the way through the end of January. So if we need to accomplish our goals, we're not starting habitat improvements till after the season and after we're done hunting. But bottom line, this is a great time of the year to shoot does. You're not spooking deer to your neighbors. You're not spooking bucks to your neighbors or shooting, because typically no one else is in the woods. Very low percentage of hunters are hunting right now, and you've already made it through that great time to actually make an impact on your herd by promoting bucks to the next age class, by protecting bucks, by having a great hunt, by improving sex ratios. And because you've done all that and left your property alone, now you can actually go and work on the third component of building a quality herd and the QDM principles, which is maintaining populations of deer within balance of the habitat. This is a great time. Now that you've done your work, you've left your land unpressured, you've only spooked deer when you shot them in the form of bucks, you've turned the rifle towards a doe if you already have a buck on the ground, and right now you reap the rewards of that, because it's pretty easy to go pick off some does and harvest them and get them off the land and use that venison, enjoy shooting those does, and this is a perfect time of the year to do it. I invite you to go out and enjoy these doe season opportunities if you need to shoot those does. We have my son Dante and his buddy Alec. They're going on the land starting Friday, and they're going to shoot some does, probably on two properties. We're trying to hit that number of 3 to 4 does. Some years we don't shoot any, some years we've shot more. My buddy Skip Rudder and I, back in 2007, maybe we shot 9 does in basically a half day of hunting in this time period, because we'd allowed the food plots and the property to sit and not be overpressured. So when we needed to take some out, we actually took 12 that year. That was the most we've ever taken out around here. We were able to do so in a half day of hunting, instead of having to hammer our land over and over, instead of having to shoot the does during bad times. You just left your property sit and ripen for the best time to take does. Right now, to me, is the best time to take the does, because of all the opposite reasons that the worst time to take a doe is opening day of gun season, let alone the first few days of gun season, unless you already have a buck on the ground. Take advantage of December, these late size season times, to take deer off your property. Just think about that, that you're improving sex ratios and populations and browsing pressure on your land for next season. And think about it pretty black and white as far as, and I know some people that take a lot of does right before the season begins, September, you know, crop damage permits, and that's also a bad time, because you take 12, 13 deer off the land, even if you think you need to, you might not have many deer in October running around and for the rut. So enjoy this doe season time. It's a fun time. We've had a great time, especially between Christmas and New Year's, taking does with our bows throughout the years, going back into the late 80s. It's been one of my favorite times to take does. I participated in that almost every year since 1986, and it's a joy to do so, and I hope you can enjoy it this holiday season. And please enjoy the holidays. Have a Merry Christmas, safe New Year, and I hope you enjoy these videos this year in the late season.